Thank you. welcome to stay here and stay in your seats, but if you want to see the arrival of the hearse, feel free to proceed outside, and he'll be here in just a few minutes.
Edmund Gwenn, we talk a little bit about him, talk a little bit more about the work that Arthur and I have done. You'll all have a chance to come and pay your respects to Edmund before he is interned, and he'll be home for the holidays. So thank you again to everyone.
I reached out to the family in England, since they couldn't be here, and asked if they wanted to write a letter to be read here at the ceremony so that they could be here in spirit with us, and they kindly did so. So I thought it'd be fun to start by just reading a letter from Edmund Gwenn's great-nephew. I'd like to thank Arthur Dark and Jessica Wall and all of Hollywood Forever Cemetery for honoring my great-uncle by giving this urn such a wonderfully prominent niche in the Hall of Remembrance. I know how much work has gone into the complicated arrangements to achieve this result. Edmund Gwenn was my grandfather, Arthur Chesney, also an actor, were brothers. Arthur starred in The Lodger, a 1929 Hitchcock classic opposite Ivan Ravello. Edmund's career was far more successful in Hollywood terms, while Arthur prospered on the West End London stage. Sadly, the brothers suffered from a rather extreme form of sibling rivalry, as did we all know, and they were virtually estranged later in life. The reasons for this are all lost in time. While my father, the late Sir Michael Dumet, was on sabbatical from Oxford, born Edmund John Kellaway in London, England on September 26, 1877. He began his acting career on the London stage in the 1890s. Acting became something of a family affair. His brother Arthur Chesney and his cousin Cecil Kellaway were both also noted actors. And in 1901, he would marry Minnie Terry, member of the Terry dynasty of English stage performers. The marriage was short-lived, but they remained close friends throughout their lives. In that era, acting was still not seen by many as a reputable profession, particularly by Edmund's father, who disapproved in his career choice. Early on in his career in theater, Edmund would often wear disguises like a false beard and use a stage name, Edmund Gwenn, to ensure no one would recognize him and inform his father. During these early years, he would perform in many of the plays of George Bernard Shaw, like Man and Superman. His acting career was interrupted by military service during the First World War, but after peace was restored, Edmund returned to the West End stage, where he continued to hone his craft and delight audiences.
Performance by an actor in a supporting role. And this is a superlative list indeed. Charles Bickford in The Farmer's Daughter, RKO Radio. Thomas Gomez in Ride the Big Horse, Universal International. Edmund Gwenn in Miracle on 34th Street, from the Texas Park. Robert Ryan in Crossfire, RKO Radio. Richard Widmark in Kiss of Death, 20th Century Fox.
The applause may give you a clue.
The winner? Edmund Gwenn in Miracle.
Now I know that the center films. Oh, you may laugh, ladies and gentlemen. Not so easy to discern, you know. He's a most elusive little fellow. Turns up in all sorts of places under all sorts of names and disguises. First time I ever met him, he told me his name was George Seaton. And wonderfully, George Seaton had his revenge by being in tonight. About a year and a half ago, he suddenly turned up at Culver City and told me his name was Metro Goldwyn Mayer. That was the day Metro agreed to loan me the Fox to make the picture. And now, I think it's time Santa Claus added a word to his name. I think he ought to call himself Santa Claus Incorporated. Santa Claus Inc. Inc. For then, you will embrace all you wonderful, kind people who have done the honor of making me stand here tonight. Thank you, all of you, for making the evening of my life such a happy one.
Thank you. Next, I was in Vault. Arthur was tapping Vault 5, and I was in Vault 1. Listening to whatever song was playing on my Vault Tunes playlist. I was sitting on the floor cataloging names on the bottom row of one of the hundreds of shelves in the room where I was working. I faintly heard Arthur speaking to me from all the way down the hall. I turned off my music and yelled, "What?" back at him. He came into the vault and asked if I had moved Margaret Dumont. I was confused and told him no, thinking, why the hell would I move her? He then told me that he couldn't find her urn. Now, this was very puzzling because Margaret was an easy urn for us to find initially, and we both had pictures of her around with him. I said it again, and even while he descended the ladder, he still didn't believe me. I finally held up the urn with the label facing out so he could read it plain as day for himself. We made sure to double check the date on the urn with Edmund's actual death date, thinking maybe this could be some other guy with the same name. But it wasn't. It was our Edmund that we had been searching for.
To see old Kris Kringle get laid to rest here. But shed not a tear on this solemn occasion, for Santa's not dead. Do you need some persuasion? If you look to your left and you look to your right, your eyes will behold a most curious sight. Santa's, not one, but two, three, or four. Through them is the spirit of Christmases of yore. They've come here to honor their key inspiration, the Santa of film for a whole generation. He made us believe in that magic again.
In the year 1897, a short film called Santa Claus Filling Stockings was made. Another called Santa Claus and the Children was made in 1898. Santa Claus Visit was made in 1900. There have been a lot of them. Obviously, since 1897, quite a few actors have donned the red suit. Liam Bantock, Monty Woolley, Alberto Rabagliati, Jan Rood, Sebastian Cabot, David Huddleston, Sir Richard Attenborough, Paul Giamatti, Ed Asner, Tim Allen, Kurt Russell, David Harbour, and many others have all been cinematic Santas. But Edmund Gwenn was the definitive Santa. Unless you're a film buff, a student, or a Christmas movie historian, or perhaps Arthur here, there's a good possibility that Mr. Gwenn's the first Santa you saw on film. There's a saying, when they made him, they broke the mold.
Special little addendum here for his niche. An autograph from Edmund Gwenn.
And myself. We would like to give our sincerest thanks to Jessica Wall, Arthur Dark, and of course, the family of Mr. Edwin Gwenn for allowing us the privilege to have a Christmas legend be laid to rest on our grounds. We cherish his memory, and we cherish the wonderful moments he shared with the world, and may he rest in peace.
Thank you, Jessica.
I got the eye.
That's cool.
Let me get that again.